embarks on a magical journey to find the enchanted mirror of Encanta, read along with me in your book. You will know it's time to turn the page when you hear this sound. Let's begin now. High above the mainland, fairies from Pixie Hollow darted through the sky. They zipped past trees, turning the leaves crimson and gold. A sprinkle of pixie dust sweetened apples and ripened pumpkins. Autumn had always been one of the busiest seasons for the fairies, and this year was no exception. Minister of Autumn and the Queen called Tinkerbell to the royal chambers.
Since time immemorial, fairies have celebrated the end of autumn with a revelry. And this particular autumn coincides with a blue harvest moon. A new scepter must be created to celebrate the occasion.
Queen Clarion smiled at Tink.
And Fairy Mary has recommended you.
The minister continued.
The scepter must be built to precise dimensions. At the top, you will place a moonstone. When the blue moon is at its peak, its rays will pass through the gem, creating blue pixie dust.
Queen Clarion explained that blue pixie dust prepared the pixie dust tree for winter so that it could grow again in spring.
We are relying on you.
that one of the bags was glowing. She peeked inside.
with a full tummy. Tinkerbell was annoyed.
Shoo! Go find your friends!
But Blaze wouldn't budge. As it grew dark, Tinkerbell realized that his bright light would be able to help guide her way. The next day, Tink thought she saw the stone arch from Lyria's story. She anchored the balloon to a branch and left Blaze to guard it. As Tink flew closer to the arch, she realized that it was only two tangled trees. Just then, Blaze rushed up and told Tink that a gust of wind blew away their balloon.
It's gone? My compass, my supplies, my pixie dust.
At that moment, a strong wind knocked Tink over. The fairy tumbled to the ground. Then, everything went dark. When Tink woke up, she didn't know what to do.
I lost my balloon. I lost my pixie dust. I'm starving. What have I done?
Blaze called his bug friends to help. Bees brought Tink a honeycomb snack. Other bugs offered a leaf cup of water. Tinkerbell started to feel better right away. But she realized that she didn't know which direction to take to find the magical mirror.
Hey, we're lost. By any chance, have you seen a stone arch around here?
The bugs led the way. Suddenly, Tink spotted something in the distance.
The stone arch? We're here!
In Pixie Hollow, Terrence went to Tink's house to apologize. He noticed the diagram for her balloon, and something else, too.
Watch them.
Terrence scooped the pieces into a bag and set off to find Tink, wherever she was. Meanwhile, Tink and Blaze had just passed through the stone arch. Then they arrived at a bridge. The two trolls guarding the bridge were arguing, so they didn't notice when Tinkerbell and Blaze slipped past them. Tink and Blaze hurried through the crossing.
Listen, it's the ocean!
Tinkerbell knew that meant they were nearing the island. As they emerged from the bridge, a breathtaking sight awaited them. The wrecked ship!
Okay, Blaze, this is it! We gotta find that mirror and fix the moonstone. Let's go!
As they crept through the ship, Tink spotted a satchel filled with treasures, including the mirror. Tink took a deep breath.
I wish...
Blaze buzzed nervously around Tink, causing her to break her concentration. Suddenly, Blaze went silent. Tink had wasted her only wish.
Blaze, look what you've done! This is all your fault!
But Tink realized she had only herself to blame.
I'm sorry, Blaze. It's not your fault. But I wish Terrence were here. I wish we were still friends.
As a tear fell onto the mirror, Tink saw an image of Terrence.
We are friends, Tink.
All of a sudden, Terrence appeared right behind her. Tink gasped in surprise.
Terrence! How did you...
I flew all night, all day over the sea, and just when I was gonna run out of dust, I stumbled into that flying machine of yours.
Before Tink could learn more, a pack of rats appeared. Tink covered the mirror with cobwebs and used Blaze's light to cast a spooky shadow. The frightened rats ran away. The group was ready to head home. Tink used the last of her pixie dust so that her balloon would be able to they wouldn't find out until the blue moon rose. Soon it was the day of the autumn revelry. Queen Clarion, the Minister of Autumn, and all the fairies gathered together. Tink, Terrence, and Blaze arrived just in time. Tink smiled nervously.
Fairies of Pixie Hollow, I present the Autumn Scepter.
The moonbeam streamed through the moonstone crystals, showering the fairies with blue pixie dust. The Minister of Autumn gasped.
Your Majesty, I've never seen this much blue pixie dust before.
Queen Clarion beamed.
Tonight, I believe, is our finest revelry ever. Thanks to one very special fairy, Tinkerbell, and her friend, Terrence.
Yes, of course, Blaze.
The trio held the scepter high in the air, marking an autumn revelry so magnificent, it would become a fairy legend.
For worldly things will fade away as seasons come and go. But the treasure of true friendship